Hello everyone, welcome back to another video. So in this video, we are going to create this beautiful low poly scene using Blender. So without any further ado, let's get straight into the video. Before we dive in, I noticed that 95% of you watching aren't subscribed yet. Your subscription really motivates me to keep creating more content for you. So if you enjoy what you see, please hit that subscribe button and enable the bell icon so you never miss out on future videos. Let's create a plane and subdivide it several times. Press Ctrl plus T to triangulate the mesh. Now let's displace the mesh by enabling proportional editing and selecting random. Select the portion where you want your landscape to be flat and scale to 0 by pressing S and 0. Adjust the mesh to your needs. Now let's create a rock. Create an icosphere by 1 subdivisions. Now let's add some details by beveling the corners and merging vertices together. Select 2 vertices and press J to connect both the vertices. Repeat the step until you are satisfied with the shape. Let's arrange the rocks for your landscape. Repeat and follow along. Split the view into two. Create a camera. Adjust the resolution to 1080x1080 and change the focal length to around 200. Place the camera according to your scene. Now let's place the rocks for your landscape. Create a cube and we can start blocking out the house, so it will be helpful while modeling the house. This is just for a reference and we will remove it later. Now let's start modeling wooden planks for our platform. Create a cube and scale as shown. Create three loop cuts and add some details by beveling the edges. Duplicate the plank and add some more details. Add an array modifier. Create another cube for the legs of the platform, add loop cuts, and bevel the corners to add details. I model the remaining parts by just duplicating the basic shapes and scaling, so you can easily follow along. Apply the array modifier so you can extend these planks. Now we can create steps for our platform. Add some details. Add an array modifier and arrange as steps. Let's create a house by just duplicating the shapes and placing them as like. Create the walls of the house by doing the same step used to create the platform. Let's cut the windows using the knife tool. Press a C while using the knife tool so that you can cut through the shapes. And delete the unwanted faces. Repeat this on the other sides as well. I'm not bothering about the topology and mesh because it's just for an image. I'm fast-forwarding this from here because most of the steps from now on are just the repetition of the previous steps. You can slow down the video if you can't follow along. And now let's create trees. First, create a circle with 8 vertices. Select all edges and extrude, scale the edges, and create a loop cut. Select an edge and press V to split the vertices. Repeat this on all sides. Duplicate the shape and arrange it as shown in the video. Select all the shapes, enable proportional editing, and select smooth. Now scale the top shape so that other shapes also get scaled. Now let's create a tree stem. Create a cylinder with 6 sides. Add loop cuts and add some details. place the trees according to your landscape. Duplicate the steps and create another one. Let's create the water surface. This water surface is created as same as the terrain. Now let's create grass, create a plain, and follow along. Move the newly made grass model into a collection. Add a particle system to our landscape and select hair particles, scale to your requirements. Change the render as to collection and select the new collection. Play with the settings for your required scale and seed. Change to weight paint mode, and under vertex group, select group in density, and paint the area where you want the grass. Now we can add some details to the scene by adding some extra elements. Let's add lights to our scene, make sure you are on cycles, add an area light, adjust the intensity as per your needs, duplicate the lights and place them as like. The final step is texturing. Here, most of the textures used are simple plain textures with maximum roughness. Thank you. While texturing the tree, I used a color ramp for the base color for a gradient effect, and the same for the rocks. After some final adjustments, here is your final render.